So the big question is, how does this series compare to the original series?
What I would say in a great way is that I love the updating of this. I feel like my wife is actually a huge fan. We have actually all the box sets in my house of the original. And I think it's just more of the time. It's a more adult story, and it allows us to tell a deeper sort of romance, and it also allows us to plant our feet and say something about the world that we live in right now in a way that I don't know if the bones of that original show have, but I'm excited about that. That sort of crossroads of emotion and just what do we want to put out in the world.
Are there any, like, latent, like, you talk about, like, relevant tones, like, that you want to touch on? Is there anything blatant that you approach, or is it sort of subtle, suggestive?
It's all subtle. I mean, it's entertainment first, but we did talk, I mean, they are illegal aliens in the biggest way possible. So there is that sort of tract of it. There's also, too, there's a natural fear. There's a natural, in the world that we live in now, that other is very frightening. Mm-hmm. But I would say it's always about, for anyone that you meet, it's about judging. Sometimes there are good other and sometimes there are bad other. And it's about taking the time to actually interface with someone and to get to know, like, who that individual is, mm-hmm. to understand their journey. And I kind of... I like all those things, given where our country is, to bury those messages in the entertainment.
Besides from the original, are there any other influences going into, like, either the writing process or the production value of the show?
Sure. I mean, we're an Amblin show, so we often look at what are those moments and those touchstones. Like, can we do an homage to something? I mean, there's a huge breadth of sci-fi in that world, so it's always like, oh, we really like this moment from this movie. Is there a version that we can do on our own show of that? Or that nods to those sort of alien things that they've done before. Yeah.
Would you say, genre-wise, is it more sci-fi or is it more drama? Or what are you tending
towards? I would say at its core, it is a romance first.
Okay.
It is definitely and then I would say a drama, second, a life drama, second. So touchdowns, and we talk about Friday Night Lights a lot. I'd also say, like, what we sat down to break this first season, we talked a lot about murder mysteries that are unfolding, like, on streaming services and stuff. And it's like, how do we bring a version of that to CW? And Karina and I always joke, it's like, once you take a step forward, you can never take those steps back. So coming from very heavy genre stuff before, we really wanted to slow roll that out and let people fall in love. So I would say incrementally it becomes more and more sci-fi, but at a very slow pace.
How do you feel the new series will resonate with original fans?
I hope that they'll like it. I know that there's a curiosity and people love what they love from being younger. There's things that I love as well, but what I always love when they do something like this is to see the fresh take on it, how they took something that I loved and represented it in a new way. And so we did look at, like, you know, how people behave, what is our flip on that, what are our little nods to the past. It's an interesting dance, you know?
I'm always interested in the writing room process.
Sure.
So when you guys are breaking the first season, are there moments when you guys are developing it that you're like, no, we'll save that for season two?
All the time. It's funny, in starting to grow things out, I would say in any writer's room, it takes about 6 episodes for it to be like, this is the story we're actually telling. And so we wrote some stories and had discussions, and a lot of that we pushed back further. Some of it has been pulled up. But again, it's really, really about asking ourselves, like, where do we want to get? How far do we want to get at the end of this season so that we haven't burned through all the story? It doesn't go to crazy places. How do we still keep it grounded? But again, we always want to be peeking around the corner to those sci-fi elements.
How many characters are, like, at the core of the story?
It's interesting. I would say that the other thing that I've learned about the show is that it is more ensemble than I thought it was going to be. You look at that, we have the three aliens and we have Liz, but I'm fascinated by the stories that are on the periphery, and incrementally we've been taking those stories and rounding them back into the main story. So I'm curious to see how people respond to those journeys and what they start to think is our murder mystery starts to unfold.
I mean, you said it was a darker version of, or a more adult version of the last one.
Yes.
How is that working with the CW? Because, of course, the CW has always been sort of like the millennial network.
It's
getting darker.
I would say they're phenomenal first of all, as executives, they're very supportive in the story that that Karina wants to tell, and I've found that any writer that's gone to them wants to tell. So that first and foremost has been great, and they wanted to embrace it. Like I think that they're savvy and they recognize. They've been supportive, again, with anything that we want to say. They're always like, let's find the best way to do that. Let's put that out in the world and then all sort of judge. Do we hail that level of savviness or not?
CW has that kind of great relationship with Netflix that once the season's over, it goes like kind of right on there. So
yes.
Do you recommend people watch weekly, or do you think this show can be something that you can binge?
I think it does both. And I'll say this, that we've designed it in a way for once you get... that there will be joy when answers start to come to look back and say, oh, they've been peppering this through all the way. Like, if you really start to pay attention, I think people will be like, oh, that's what that person or these people were doing in this instance. That didn't quite, you didn't quite understand then, but the more that you look back, you're like, oh, I can understand now how things were being hidden or why things unfolded the way that they did. So to me, I love that when I know sometimes I want to watch it week to week and have it something to discuss and go back and I'd be like, you know what, I'm going to power these three episodes again just to be like, oh, I get what they were doing right there. Yeah.
Are you pulling storylines from the original one and kind of broadening? Are you creating something totally original with that kind of concept?
I will say that it is the source material, it goes all the way back to the books. That's what it is. So anything that we do, we're doing little nods, but technically, also legally, we can't. So it really is about creating its own entity. Its own, yeah.
So fans won't need to know the original to be able to enjoy this one.
No, I think you'll have both. There's people that knew nothing about it and have enjoyed it, and then there's other people like that have responded that I've talked to that is like, oh, I remember that from this one. That, you know, so but you want both. You want people. You want it to be enjoyable on both levels.
So you've got the box sets of the original. When was the last time you actually went back and watched them?
I watched a chunk of them early on when I knew I was going to come on to this. And then I watched I actually stopped watching. I started to have that debate, you know, about like who should know and who should not know.
Uh-huh.
And there's people in our room that really, really know it. And I was like, I think it'll be better if I don't. Because I always have someone to be like, oh, they did that or didn't do that. That's dangerous territory. Or that's, you know, all fresh snow that you should be jumping into.
How much do the actors know going in about their individual storylines and their character development?
Right.
So, because like, I remember The Good Place, they didn't tell them the big twist until like a couple episodes before
right.
they were about to film it. So, how far in advance do they know like where the story's going?
That's a good question. It's always a journey, I would say. It's like, if it can, I'm of the belief, if it can help an actor to understand where certain elements of what they're trying to get across, then we share that with them. There's some things, honestly, that we don't know, or there's some pieces I'm always reticent to tell them, because sometimes I don't want them to fall in love with the thing, and then we pull it from them or change it and be like, we're going to do that in season three now. So they know enough, that they know generally where we're going. And it's a delicate dance for them and us as we go on that journey together, I'd say.
Any plan on cameos from the original season? Sure.
We talked about, we're going to have Sherry Appleby's in a direct one.
Oh.
So there's that. Karina and I talked about it because it's not a sequel. It's always about what is the story support for that to happen. So is there something fun that a fan might enjoy? How we would make that person into that story? But we do jump times as well. So we thought about, like, how do we sneak X person in or turn their... a version of what they did on the old show upside down. Like, it doesn't make sense.